So, hello everyone. Let's continue our study of induced EMF. So, as I earlier mentioned, induced EMF is of two types. One is the dynamically induced EMF, and the other one is the statically induced EMF. This is the second one. So, dynamically induced EMF is when conductor cuts magnetic field. Statically induced EMF is when magnetic field cuts the conductor. So, or I would say circuit. So, conductor, it should be closed circuit, conductor or circuit. Now, we have studied dynamically induced EMF in the previous videos. So, we had seen what is the EMF equation, and EMF equation is so BLV, whereas flux density, length and velocity and so on. So, now we come to study the statically induced EMF. So, in this case, the circuit is stationary and the magnetic field is moving. Okay. So, let's study that statically induced EMF. So, statically induced EMF again consists of two types. Okay. So, that is self-induced EMF and then mutually induced EMF. Okay. So, let's study these two. So, first let's do mutually induced EMF. Okay. Mutually induced EMF. Okay. So, the idea is, I take one magnetic core. On this magnetic core, I have two windings. This is winding one. So, it's just wound like this, and then another winding. So, this winding is A and this winding is called B. So, we have solved enough problems to understand that having a core will definitely reduce the magnetic reluctance. So, this is the core which is reducing the magnetic reluctance. In fact, instead of having a core like this, because this side is an air gap, it will have a much higher reluctance. So, let's delete all this and then consider another case. So, this time, let's have a core something like this. So, it's like a closed magnetic path. So, because this magnetic path offers very low reluctance, so the entire flux that is generated will be inside this. Okay, so I have one coil here and I have another coil here. So let's call this coil A and let's call this coil B. Okay. So on coil A, what I'll do is I have a resistance which can be varied, and then I have a voltage source. So, let's say the resistance and voltage, we can assume some values, but for the time being, we'll not do that. And here, I have a galvanometer or a voltmeter, which can measure the voltage. Okay. So, what I want to do now is, the moment this circuit is closed, there will be some current flowing in this circuit. So let's call it IA. So some current IA is flowing. So because this is a DC voltage, we'll assume that this coil's resistance is negligible as compared with this one, because I'm adding an external resistance. So, and what I'm trying to do is, let's assume some values. So this value is, let's say 10 volts. And then let's say this is, it's a variable resistance. So I can start with, let's say 2, 4, and then maybe 6, 8, and 10 ohms. Okay. So initially, I can increase the resistance value in different steps. Okay. So resistance can be 2 ohms, 4 ohms, 6 ohms, 8 ohms, and 10 ohms. So what I'll do is, I'll take time, let's say at 0 seconds, I use 2 ohms. At 10 seconds, I use 4 ohms. I just jump to 4 ohms. At 20 seconds, I jump to 6 ohms. At 30 seconds, I jump to 8 ohms. And finally, at 40 seconds, I jump to 10 ohms. So this is the experiment I do for 40 seconds. And every time, I'm just jumping the resistance. Okay. So now I can calculate what is the current. Okay. So what will be the current in the IA? So whenever like the voltage is 10 volts, so I is nothing but V by R. So 10 by 2 is 5 amperes. Okay. So otherwise 10 by 4 is 2.5 amperes. 10 by 6. Okay. So what is 10 by 6? I think it is 1.67 amperes. Then 10 by 8, okay, so 10 divided by 8, so I think it is 1.25 amperes, and finally 10 by 10 is 1 ampere, okay. So if you actually see, the current starts at 5, then suddenly jumps to 2.5, then 1.67, then, so the current IA is in this format, okay. So whenever current is changing, what happens in this, okay, so there is a flux that is set up in this. So phi A, that flux that is set up in this travels to this core, and then that flux also links with this one, phi A. Okay. Now, whenever there is a coil and then flux linkages are there, the rate of change of flux linkages will determine the EMF induced. Okay. So my question now is, what is the value of this V? Okay. So, or let's call this as VB, because this is coil B. So what is VB? So VB. Now the current is in this case 5 amperes. So as long as the current is constant, okay, so let's say at 0 seconds the current is 2 amperes. So 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 10 seconds, there is no change in the current. So what is the flux linkages? So there is no change in the flux linkages also. So current proportional to 5 amperes, some current will flow here, some flux will flow here, then proportional to that there will be some this one. So between 0 to 10 seconds, there will be no VB. Just before 0 there might be a VB, but that we will not consider. So VB is equal to 0. Okay. Now at 10 seconds, there is a sudden change in the current. Therefore, there is a sudden change in the flux. Therefore, the flux linkages is changing. Therefore, some EMF is induced in the VB. Okay. Some EMF is induced. Okay. So, since the current is reducing, the VB EMF will be induced in such a way so as to increase the current. Okay. So as to generate a flux in this direction to add to the earlier flux. So, VB, let's consider that as some value VB. Again, from 10 point some, you know, minor, I'm just assuming as 0.1, to 20 seconds, there won't be any, VB will be 0. Then at 20 seconds, there will be again a VB. Similarly, at 30 seconds, again, you will have some VB. Okay? So if I want to show it as a diagrammatically, so you have 0 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and 40 seconds. So the first plot is IA. Okay. So IA is 5 amperes, then it becomes 2.5 amperes, then it becomes 1.6 amperes. So some current is reducing like this. So what will be the VB? So wherever there is a current is changing, flux is changing. So therefore VB is normally 0, then there will be a spike here. Similarly, again it is 0, then there will be a spike here. Again it will be 0, then there will be a short spike here. Again it will be 0, then there will be a short spike here. So this is nothing but VB. So EMF induced in the second coil whenever there is a change in the current in the first coil. So this is an example of statically induced EMF. Because coil A is static, coil B is also static. So only variable is the flux is varying, so therefore the varying magnetic field is inducing EMF into it. And this is also statically induced EMF, and the subtype is mutually induced EMF. Mutually induced EMF. Because this is between A and B. Okay. So I hope with this you understood what is mutually induced EMF. Now if I go forward, now I'll explain self-induced EMF. Just repeat the same experiment with only one coil. Okay. So let's say I have a core which provides me a magnetic path. So on this core I have only one coil with a variable resistance and a voltage. Okay. So this is a DC voltage again. So this is a variable resistance. Coil A is there, that's all. Okay. So again, let's do the same thing. So this is 10 volts DC, and then the resistance can be 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So whenever there is a change in the current, the flux is changing. The changing flux is actually linking with the coil A itself. So there is a change in ampere turns in coil A. Therefore, some voltage is induced in coil A. Okay. So that is the thing. Okay. So that is called self-induced EMF. So some voltage is induced. So let me, to measure that voltage, let's connect a voltmeter here. Now this voltmeter will not read this voltage. Okay. So this voltage is fixed. This is 10 volts. Okay. So whereas this is the voltage across the coil, and this is the resistance. Okay. So let's say this is voltage across the resistance VR, and this is V. Okay. So this is always 10, and this VR is some voltage, and then this some voltage is being measured. So again, to show you in the form of a plot, so this is my x-axis and this is y-axis. 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, 40 seconds. So this is time in seconds. And in the first is I draw IA. So the same thing. The IA is like this, reducing. So whenever there is a change in IA, there is a change in VA also. So there will be a spike in VA. So something like this. Otherwise the VA is zero. Okay. So this is self-induced EMF. So why this EMF is coming? Because the EMF induced is nothing but rate of EMF induced is nothing but N d phi by dt. So here I will also indicate minus sign to just say that this is opposing the very cause of its production. So d phi, there is a d phi because the current itself is changing. So whenever current is changing, the flux is changing, and therefore there is a self-induced EMF. So in this example, actually we can be a little bit more specific. So here the current was 5 amperes because 10 volts divided by 2 ohms is 5 amperes, and here the current is 2.5 amperes. Okay. So what was VR in the earlier case? Okay. So VR is so at t equal to 10 minus, that means before 10 seconds. So VR is nothing but 5 amperes into 2 ohms. So the total 10 volts is dropping here. And 10 volts is supply voltage, 10 volt is a voltage drop. So the voltage across the coil is 0. Now at T equal to 10 plus, what is VR? Now the VR is supposed to be 2.5 amperes into 4. So that is again supposed to be 10 volts. But immediately the current will not jump from 5 to 2.5. There will be some time gap. So in the meanwhile, what happens is there will be some voltage induced in this. Okay? So I think that will be again, how much will that be? 2.5 amperes into 4. I think for that we need to know what is the inductance of the coil. So I think we'll come back to this problem with more accurate calculation, with calculating the inductance and then the voltage. Only thing is that there will be a spike like this. Whenever there is a change in the current, there will be a spike. Okay. So another thing that you can see is you can have the basically like a transformer. So there is a core like this. With one primary coil and one secondary coil, and here I will give an alternating current, okay, alternating voltage, therefore alternating current, therefore there will be alternating flux. Whenever alternating flux links with the coil, it will induce an alternating EMF. So here I can use a voltmeter and measure the voltage. So the amount of voltage that is coming at this second coil will be proportional to the turns ratio. So if there are more turns here, the same flux is linking with both. So depending on number of turns, the voltage will be there. So this is in the case of AC. So that is also another example of mutually induced EMF. So I think in this video, I'm just giving you a qualitative idea about what is self-induced EMF and what is mutually induced EMF. One more doubt you can have is, when I am explaining this diagram, because of change in IA, there is some change in the phi A flux that induces some voltage in VB. Will it also induce voltage in VA? So the answer is yes. Okay. So even in this plot, in the first case also, so VB is, there is a spike. VA also there will be a spike. So this one is VA. So both self-induced EMF and mutual induced EMF, both together happen. The EMF induced in coil A is called self-induced EMF, and the EMF induced in coil B is called mutual induced EMF. So in this video, I just wanted to give you a general idea about the classification of induced EMF, and then what is a self-induced EMF and what is mutual induced EMF. Okay. So in both the cases, the circuit is fixed, and the magnetic field is moving, or magnetic field is cutting. Okay. So let's do some more theory, some more expressions and equations, and followed by some problems on this topic of statically induced EMF.